Welcome to another lightsaber duel analysis. Today we are discussing the duel between Luke and Vader on Cloud City. This particular duel, in and of itself, was also a turning point for the franchise in regards to adding some actual fighting forms into its choreography. If you have seen my video concerning the duel on the Death Star 2, I mentioned Bob Anderson as the fight choreographer, and just like in Return of the Jedi, he was the one in the suit for this duel during the film. It was a huge step forward visually, and beyond that, I find that this duel unfolded in such an interesting, calculating way that doubled down nicely on the film's overall theme. This duel is basically an extension of the recurring circumstances the Rebellion is facing against the Empire starting from the beginning of the film. It's a game of cat and mouse, the prey and the hunted. The Rebellion is always running, fleeing, or falling into traps. And the culmination of all of this is Luke attempting to take on Vader, not even yet fully realizing the full extent of what Vader really is, and what he really wants from him. So first things first, I want to talk about the set and setting used as this duel unfolds. To me, the Carbonite Freeze Chamber's color scheme and the way it's lit looks like something straight out of a horror movie. And oddly, what always comes to my mind as something that feels similar to this is the boiler room from Nightmare on Elm Street. In the audio commentary for The Empire Strikes Back, George Lucas even referenced this set as hell, with the doors closing at Luke's feet being like teeth and all this steam creating a strange, surreal atmosphere. It's a setting where the dominant sounds aren't the score, but the screeching of metal and the hissing of gas and the clashing of the lightsabers. It's not like Duel of the Fates where the music greatly intensifies the glory of the fight. And yeah, that fight is glorious. Rather, in Empire, the lack of music, the dark color scheme, and the backlighting of characters generates fear and tension. And as we follow Luke through this duel, things get more claustrophobic, isolating, and tense. Like I said, it really is like a horror film with Vader trying to capture his victim for later use. And one other interesting detail I actually never put together until doing a bit of research for this video is that Luke's vision of Vader ends up literally playing out from a framing perspective. The cave vision has a dreamlike quality due to the slow frame rate it has, but as you can see, visually, the cave itself foreshadows the physical location for Luke and Vader's fated showdown. And whether intentional or not, the duel's final reveal is seemingly implied in the very vision in the cave. So, as the duel begins, Vader taunts Luke saying, "The Force is with you, young Skywalker, but you are not a Jedi yet." This is my favorite line from Vader ever. But what I like about it beyond the delivery is how unnerving it sounds, because Vader is standing there, completely motionless, a Sith silhouette with not even his lightsaber ignited. He's just watching Luke. And if you think about it, it's the first time he has ever really seen his son. Until it was revealed who destroyed the Death Star, Vader had thought his children were dead. Luke sees Vader standing at the top of a set of stairs and slowly makes his way to who he presumes to be the murderer of his father and the killer of his former master, Obi-Wan Kenobi. Luke, in a very un-Jedi-like fashion, decides to ignite his lightsaber, trying to prove that he's not afraid of facing this monster, and Vader follows suit, igniting his. And after a moment of consideration, Luke finally delivered a series of two strikes, both of which were easily blocked by Vader. I feel like we usually see Vader with both hands on his saber, but here he is peering with one hand. If Vader wanted to, he could destroy Luke at any moment of his choosing. But as I have said, this is a bit of a game with Vader. Just like in Return of the Jedi, in this duel, Vader doesn't want to kill Luke. However, as we will see, he eventually does unleash a taste of his full fury on his son. Luke attempts another strike at Vader from overhead, but again, Vader blocks it one-handed. It forces Luke back, causing him to lose his footing, falling down to the ground. And although Luke is keeping his lightsaber ignited and pointed towards Vader throughout all of this, if Vader wanted to kill Luke, he could have right when he fell to the ground. And this is something that Luke brings up in Return of the Jedi. Once Luke is back on his feet, we follow a series of 10 strikes, culminating in the first time we see how dangerous lightsabers really are on screen. Luke starts off with another very fast series of strikes, all blocked by Vader easily. However, here we finally see Vader test Luke, bringing down his own saber overhead, which is blocked by Luke in the nick of time. It is also my belief that Vader was swinging specifically for Luke's head with his second strike, just to see how skilled his son has become, just to test him out. Luke does block the incoming blow, and now for a bit, Vader is using a bit more skill against his son, continuing to test his power. The culmination of Vader's next series of attacks is seeing his blade slice through metal after Luke ducked out of the way, and as I stated, it's the first time we as the audience have seen a lightsaber do something like this. Sure, we've seen it cut off an arm, but now we've seen it cut through metal. This was intentional, and visually just really helps hammer home how dangerous the lightsabers are. Although a bit of the choreography here can seem a bit predictable, what always stays timeless for me is the effectiveness of how eerie the setting is while being absent of music. This is something I mentioned earlier. All we get are these loud sound effects, and to me that's why the blade cutting through the metal really does stick out, and it's also a foreshadow of what's to come concerning Luke and his duel. Now, in the film itself, it cuts away from the duel to the other side plot at this moment, but when we return, it's seemingly after another series of attacks from Vader, slowly forcing Luke further backwards, into his trap. As they pause, Vader tells Luke that he has learned much, and Luke finally displays his own hubris in this duel by being a bit arrogant in his own ability. Luke may have come here for a noble reason to save his friends, but he absolutely wants to prove himself here, which makes him vulnerable. After he states to Vader that he's full of surprises, Luke tries to strike fast at Vader, first at Vader's head and what seems to be his leg second. However, Vader can still block everything that his son has, regardless of his innate power in the Force. Vader circle parries Luke's lightsaber right out of his hand, leaving him defenseless for the first time in this duel. Again, this sets up Luke's trajectory as this duel would continue. As Luke is down on one knee, Vader half-heartedly slashes at his son, forcing him to fall backwards down the stairs, right into the exact area where Han was frozen in carbonite. Vader's plan is succeeding. In the way Vader flies down towards Luke, at the edge of the steps, is haunting to see. It reminds me of Batman visually, but mostly it's that horror vibe that I've been mentioning surrounding this entire duel itself. Vader is portrayed in a much darker way in Empire Strikes Back, you know, all the way down to how James Earl Jones would pronounce certain words. Vader was truly scary to watch in Empire, and this duel highlights that change in character. With his saber pointed towards Luke, who now stands upon the precipice of the freezing chamber, Vader tells Luke that his destiny now lies with him. Even his former master knew this to be true. And we can see Luke searching for a way out. Luke defies Vader's call to the dark side, but not knowing where he is, Vader takes one slash at Luke and Luke falls right into the carbonite chamber. Here is where everything changes in this duel. When the stakes go from I'm just playing around to straight up hostile with intent to injure if necessary. At first, Vader is actually disappointed in how easy it was for Luke to fall into the trap that he had laid out. He had hoped for something more, as he had said, all too easy. But Luke isn't quite done yet, since we see him jump to safety before he could be frozen in carbonite. And now as Vader contemplates out loud about Luke not being as strong as the Emperor had thought, we hear the clanking of metal overhead. Luke's holding on to all the piping and hoses above him. I personally love Vader's taunts to Luke here because, on the one hand, he actually is impressed with this display of ability, and on the other, he's trying to get Luke to unleash his own anger. The way this particular part of the duel was filmed reminded me of scenes where a person is maybe hiding just out of reach of some monster's arm, you know, like they're in a little nook and you can just see the big arm coming in clawing at the person, inches away from snatching them. And again, it's that horror element of this duel that stays really consistent throughout everything that we see. As Luke jumps back down onto the platform, he uses one of the hoses Vader slashed in two against him, spraying the gases right back into Vader's face. It's clear from the audio that this affected him in some way, and while I was unable to acquire exact information on if this is true, it is my belief that it was potentially part of the compounds that aids in the carbonite freezing process. You know, something along those lines, which would affect Vader's suit and his breathing apparatus. As we saw in the beginning of the film, Luke can now summon his saber. He has figured out that Force ability. And as he does so, at that moment, he is again locked up with Vader. Vader is finally seeing that his son, this son of his, actually does have raw, untamed power. Since this duel isn't going the way that Vader had thought, he continues with his attempts to pull Luke towards the dark side, and by mentioning Obi-Wan's name over and over in my head, that's an attempt to push Luke's anger until it actually is unleashed. I do believe for a moment Luke gave into his anger at Vader in order to overpower him for that brief period of time. There was a series of insignificant strikes as Vader was talking to Luke. Those were more keeping each other on their feet. However, once Luke flips over one of Vader's strikes, Luke comes at Vader with such a ferocity that had yet to occur in the duel so far. Now Luke is forcing Vader backwards, or Vader's pretending. And finally, it's Vader this time who falls off the ledge into darkness. The duel pauses momentarily, because now Vader, at least in my opinion, needs to switch up his plan for obtaining Luke as a tool to destroy the Emperor. And we move into our second set of this duel, which is below the carbonite freezing chamber. As Luke ventures on, things get narrower. The doors close behind him, trapping him again in this duel with Vader. Now, I've always found the frame where Luke briefly stares at the round window really fascinating, and it's really for one reason. And I've heard a few other people talk about this, but that window looks like a spider web. And to me, it looks like Luke was briefly staring at the center of that web. It's like he realizes he's caught in a web himself, basically foreshadowing the futility of his escape from Vader. Now, our cue to Vader looming around is his breath, and we actually don't hear it for a moment. But when we do, Luke transitions back into a defensive stance. And it's here that we see the repeated framing occur that we saw in the cave vision on Dagobah. I also love that at first, we don't get to see what Luke sees. We just stare and stay on Luke. Vader walks into frame and we track with him, and it's like a shark on the prowl. Now, Vader is absolutely done playing nice with Luke, and the fact that the score comes in full force here lets us know who is now taking over and taking control. Luke thinks Vader is about to deliver another series of powerful attacks, and sure, he is, but not how Luke suspects. Vader sends random pieces of this control room hurtling towards Luke with the Force to distract him while he goes in for the blow with his saber. And initially, Luke cuts through the metal flying towards him while also parrying Vader's attacks. Vader can see that something more disorienting needs to happen, and he sends metal flying into his son's head. And just to hyper-focus on one very small detail of this scene that I find brilliant, and most likely accidental because of the editing, is how Vader steps back after the initial Force shrapnel blows to Luke's head. It's a quick edit, but the fast exactness of Vader's body movement, with the unnerving, just unblinking stare of the mask, gives this sense of unease and tension to me. Now, I'd say the need for gestures and Force use is up for debate. However, I love how Vader tilts his blade downwards, like he's signifying the direction of where he wants all the debris to fly, which is towards Luke. And it also makes the fact that we know that this is his son all the more disturbing. The hindsight thing, I always bring this up in all the duels, how looking back, you kind of look at all these duels in a brand new way, and that definitely happened while putting this video together. Now, I'm not sure if Vader knew this or not, but that entire space outside of the window was extremely low pressure. So once the glass broke, without being powerful enough in the Force, Luke was going to fly out of it no matter what. And for me, I think that's a really wild risk to take for someone hellbent on turning their own son to the dark side for their own personal gain. The sound itself of the depressurization is terrifying. It's almost like a TIE fighter, but slowed way down with way more of a scratchy, beefy quality to it. And Luke is unable to hold on and is sucked through the window, just like I had mentioned, all the way down to another part of the innards of Cloud City. And this functions as our final setting for the duel. Vader, who was able to hold his ground as the pressure stabilized, walked over to see what had become of his son. And for me, I actually think for a second, he thought that he caused his son to fall to his death. And ironically, this sort of does occur in a few moments, in a way, but instead he sees that Luke caught onto the platform, barely hanging on, looking absolutely exhausted from this entire experience. And then after that, Vader is nowhere to be seen. Luke ends up walking back inside of the area where he had fallen from, only to be met with a ferocious downward striking blow of Vader's lightsaber. We see how frightened Luke is at this point. We stay focused on Vader, who looms large like a giant over Luke Skywalker, forcing him backwards into the catwalk that hovers over this grand abyss. This is that isolation that I was talking about very early on. Luke is completely alone here, alienated from anything and anyone that could help him. It's just him and Vader in this enormous space alone, and there's no running from this duel. On the catwalk, you can hear the sound design change mildly to reflect the fact that they are inside of this enormous empty area. And again, we are back to zero score. It's the breathing of Vader and the clashing of sabers as our sonic landscape. We see Vader forcing Luke further back from a high vantage point, and we also see more examples of how dangerous lightsabers are as they cut through more pieces of metal as they fight. And finally, Vader pushes Luke down, his blade fully extended at Luke's head, telling him that he is beaten. And for the briefest moment, it looks like Luke is so afraid that he is about to give up. But in one last burst of what I would say is anger towards Vader, Luke pushes his blade aside, again getting up to his feet, and he gets away before Vader could come down hard with a blow clearly intended to wound Luke. And from here, Vader is now pretty much full-on trading blows with Luke. But he knows full well that the end result needs to be not killing Luke. He still needs Luke alive for his own purposes. And as they are dueling, Luke actually gets one significant strike on Vader's right arm. He actually wounds him. And for me, I'd say it's extremely significant that Luke struck Vader in that part of the body, a part of his body that is still flesh. And from his groan, it would seem that the pain he felt was great. And this leads Vader to viciously slash out, cutting through three large beams of metal. And finally, as Luke strikes out at Vader with one hand, Vader uses this opportunity to circle parry yet again Luke's strike, exposing his wrist and slicing right through it, cutting off his hand. Just like we saw when Vader cut through the three pieces of metal, leaving those cauterized wounds, you can imagine what the top of the flesh looks like where the blade cut through Luke's hand. Vader, even though he could have finished this duel long before, has now won. It's entirely over for Luke, who is down one hand and one lightsaber. Now, while my video is called Lightsaber Duel Analysis, Vader's true killing blow was delivered without a swing of the blade. Vader's reveal of who he is to Luke, after Luke had failed at taking out the so-called murderer of his father, quite literally turns his worldview upside down. And we see this happen visually as he tumbles around the innards of Cloud City until he falls outside. Luke came to Bespin to save his friends, and he failed with Han. Luke came to face Vader because of what he did to his father and Obi-Wan, and now he finds out this monster is his actual father. Everything Luke knew about who he was until this very moment was a lie. And this is what Vader was trying to prey on when revealing who he is. Oh, you'll never join me? You'll never join your father? And in a way, this does create some darkness inside of Luke, as we saw in some of the recent comics for the current Star Wars run. Because after this duel, Luke struggles with his identity in a significant way. Imagine always wanting to find out who your father is, and then finding out that it's a Sith Lord. But on top of that, this Sith is showing a bit of compassion now, trying to convince you to join him to rule the galaxy, using the father-son aspect to his advantage. It truly would destabilize Luke dramatically. Now, at this point, Luke has to make a choice. Leave with Vader, or fall, presumably, to his death. And we can see him considering this carefully as Vader continues to talk. But finally, Luke chooses death rather than ever letting him be used as a tool of the dark side, or to be corrupted by his father. Now, hopefully you've never seen the version of this duel where Luke screams as he falls through the giant expanse that is Cloud City. It actually undermined the intent of the scene, which is Luke choosing death over the dark side. And Luke doing this dramatically affects Vader in a way that he never anticipated. You could say it was very similar to how Kylo Ren became unbalanced after killing his own father. Vader felt rejected by his son. He felt betrayed, and he felt angry. And that's not something Vader is used to, at least in regards to relationships with people. Sure, he essentially lives in a state of depression beneath the mask, but the fact that his own son had chosen death over him truly devastated Vader. And this was also the intent of the film and this scene. While we know that Luke survived by being saved by Leia, we end up seeing just how compromised Vader is after the rejection of his son. When the Falcon escapes the clutches of the Empire, Vader doesn't kill anyone on the bridge. For the first time in the film, when something doesn't go according to Vader's plans, he doesn't outright murder an officer. Instead, he doesn't know what to think. He doesn't know how to sit with the rejection that he's feeling. And then he takes one last look out at the empty space and walks away. Now, that is the end of this analysis, and yes, I realize that this was a bit more than just breaking down the choreography of the duel itself and focusing on forms. I find that it's integral to discuss how the fight itself is portrayed as much as it is important to talk about what happens between the two players. For me, this is the tensest fight of the entire saga, based on the fact that this duel was basically like watching a horror movie villain stalk its prey. And the fact that it relied so heavily on its own atmosphere and sound design to push the duel forwards is remarkable. So I hope you have enjoyed my dive into Luke vs. Vader on Cloud City. If you are new to the channel, please be sure to check out my other lightsaber analysis videos, as well as my other content too. And if you like today's video, please make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications. May the Force be with you, and AT-AT is signing off.